Hello friends, I hope you enjoyed watching the last video where with the help of several activities, we understood the reflection of ourselves and the objects around us. If you remember, I saw my inverted image on the concave surface of the spoon and an erect image on the convex surface. You must also have made this effort at home. If not, then you should definitely try it.
A question came to my head that in the case of a convex mirror, we can place the objects in two positions only,
one at infinity and the other one is between the infinity and the pole. But in case of concave mirrors, will there be only two cases or more? Will the image formed be erect or inverted? Virtual or real? Let us try to find out the answers to these questions.
As we know that in case of concave mirror, all the points lie in the front. So we can make six different cases by placing the object at six different positions.
The object can be placed at infinity, beyond C, at C, between C and F, at F, and the last one is between F and P.
So let us see what will be the effect on the image when we place the object at these six positions.
To perform this activity, we need a concave mirror, a stand, a candle, a small white screen and a long strip of a chart. It is a concave mirror having a focal length of 20 centimeters. How much? 20 centimeters. So I will mark a point P on one side of this chart. What will we mark? Point P. If the focal length is 20 centimeters, then F must be at a distance of 20 cm, and we already know that the radius of curvature is twice the focus length. Then C can be marked at a distance of 40 cm from P. I will place the stand on P and the concave mirror on it. Case 1. If the candle is placed far away, say at infinity, and the screen somewhere in the middle of the candle and the mirror.
The screen should be moved back and forth until a sharp image is formed on the screen.
I get this point only when I put the screen at the focus. The size of the image is very small and we can see the image on the screen. So it is real.
Let's fill it in our observation table.
Case 2. If the candle is placed beyond C, then I'll get reflection on the screen when the screen is placed between F and C. Here as well. The size of the image is smaller than the object and real and inverted in nature. Case 3. If the candle is placed at C, then the image will also be formed at C. The size of the image will be the same as the candle, but the nature will be real and inverted. Case 4. If the candle is placed between C and F, then we will get the image beyond the C. The size of the image is enlarged and nature is real and inverted. Case 5. If the candle is placed at F, then the image will be seen to be formed at infinity, highly enlarged in size and real and inverted in nature. Case 6. In the last case, if the candle is placed between F and P, then the image will not be formed on the screen, but it will appear to be formed behind the mirror as in the case of convex mirrors. Size will remain enlarged and nature will be virtual and erect.
So friends, by this activity, we can conclude that a concave mirror can form any kind of image, erect or inverted, real or virtual, large or diminished.
In most cases, the concave mirrors converge the light at a point. Hence, they are also called converging mirrors. In the same way, convex mirrors diverge, so are called diverging mirrors.
Due to the converging nature, concave mirrors are commonly used in torches, searchlights, and vehicles' headlights to get powerful parallel beams of light. They are also used as shaving mirrors to see larger images.
I hope you have found this video really interesting and have learned new things from this as well. So it's time for me to leave. Till then, you can have a look at this table. Bye.